This is the night the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it because we have a choice. Amen? See, God has given us a free will. Everyone say, you got a free will. The whole thing is we want to give up our will to do His will. Amen? And so doing that, there is a process. Everything in the kingdom is a process. Welcome to Holy Ghost Boot Camp Officers Training School. Hallelujah. We're being trained up for an eternal purpose in a temporary realm. Does everybody get that? Everyone say, I'm being trained for an eternal purpose in a temporary realm. What an awesome thing that is. I mean, really. Can you imagine God pulled me and you out of darkness? He didn't expect you to understand it at first. And you may not understand it for a little bit, but you will eventually get understanding. First of all, one of the things He wants you to do is desire to get understanding. Amen? He won't give you anything that you're not desiring for. Of course, He tries to prevent to get you things that you desire that are not good for you. Amen? So we want to get up to a place where we desire the things that we know are pleasing to Him, and its purpose is to expand the kingdom. Because one day we're going to give up our last breath and it's going to be over with. And we'll be standing before the Lord. Actually, we stand before Him every single day. Every moment, every decision. Everything you do is recorded. Nobody gets away with nothing. But it shouldn't be in the arena that we're so concerned about being recorded or having to give out, be involved in judgment at the final day. The whole thing is if you have a relationship with the Lord, there's no problem. You should have a desire to want to do His will. Amen? You want to tell people what God has done for you. The whole thing is letting God, giving Him the opportunity to do something for you, in you. It always starts in you first. It's like pulling a sock inside out. That's what He does with us. And it removes all the stuff out of there. In John 16, would you go there with me? John 16 and verse 5. Jesus was speaking to the disciples and people. He said, but now I go away to Him who sent me, and none of you ask me, where are you going? But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your heart. Nevertheless, I tell you the what? Truth. In other words, when Jesus is saying, nevertheless, I tell you the truth, He's getting ready to tell you something vitally important. Look at the next sentence. It is to your what? Come on, say it again. It is to your what? Advantage. Advantage. It is to your what? Advantage. It is to your advantage. If Jesus said, I got something that's to your advantage, you better take hold of it. Has everybody got it? How many of y'all want spiritual advantage? Amen. He said, it's to your advantage that I go away. Man, they were probably freaking out. Wait a minute, don't leave us. Who's going to protect us? How are we going to do this? He said, it's to your advantage that I go away, for if I don't go away, the Helper will not come to you. So He was giving us a revelation here, or actually what we call an illumination, although you can call it revelation. That it would be to your advantage to have the Helper. It's to your advantage. He said it would be to your advantage. But, you know, when the Helper comes to you, but if I depart, I'll send Him to you. In verse 8, and when He has come, He will what? Convict the world of sin. Why? Because it's going to be to your advantage. And of righteousness and judgment. Remember, this is to our advantage. Of sin, because they do not believe in me. Of righteousness, because I go to my Father and you see me no more. Of judgment, because the ruler of this world is judged. What an advantage. Who's the ruler of this world? Satan and his kingdom. He said something very important in verse 12. He says, I still got a lot of things I want to explain to you. I want to tell you, but you're not going to get it. But you cannot bear them. In other words, you will not understand what I'm telling you. You won't understand the multidimensional language that I have for you. You won't understand the things that I'm trying to bring to you, that you may see in every dimension possible. You won't understand that I have a knowledge and understanding that you need to have, but you're not going to get it yet. I still have many things to say to you. However, in verse 13, when he, the Spirit of what? Truth has come, who is actually the Spirit of the Father. Remember, we talked about this. He's the Spirit of the Father. Can you imagine the creator of all universe, who was, who is, and always will be, sent us the Spirit, sharing a part of himself carried by the Holy Spirit into me and you. He said, look it. However, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will what? He's going to guide you into all truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will tell you things to come. That's why it's important to practice a relationship with the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. It says, he will glorify me, for he will take of what is mine and do what? He's going to declare it to you. All things that the Father has are mine. Therefore, I said that he will take of mine and what? Declare it to you. This is phenomenal. Pulled out of darkness. Pulled out of a realm that's bound by time. Placed into another realm. With an eternal purpose in a temporary place. Hoping that we don't stay caught up into this place. The advantage to all things. He's given us an advantage to what? To all things that pertain to existence on this planet, of things seen and unseen. All existence. That's wild. It's to your advantage. By knowing the truth that is in Jesus, by his Spirit, that will guide us, that will warn us, and foretell the enemy's tactics. He's the one that tells you what the enemy's getting ready to do if you're listening. He will tell you not only the enemy's tactics, but the Lord's strategies to overcome. Overcome what? To overcome, he gives you strategies to overcome and attack so that you're able to attack and escape. Does everybody get it? Everyone say, God will give me strategies to attack and to escape. I can't emphasize enough. He said, this is to your advantage. It's how many times people neglect this. People wonder why people fall, because they're not taking advantage. Listen, if you're not going to take the advantage, the enemy will take the advantage. Amen? That's his job. In John chapter 10. John 10, verse 7. Is everybody there? Let's speak it. Then Jesus said to them all again, most assuredly I say to you, I am the door of the sheep. And all whoever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. The thief, the devil, does not come to... Whoa, he comes to what? To steal, to kill, and to destroy. But I have come that they may have life and that they may have it. That they may have it what? More abundantly. The only way you're going to get life more abundantly is to take the advantage. It's called spiritual advantage. And who's the advantage? The Holy Spirit is who gives you advantage over everything. Life abundantly comes by having the advantage to know what is. I'm going to share this. Are you ready? To know what is. To know what's going on right now. To know what was, that's pertaining to what is. And to know what is to come. See, is the Holy Spirit bound by time? No. Is he multidimensional? Is he omnipresent? Ooh. So if you're filled with the Spirit, You have access to everything, past, present, and future. See, but most people don't connect in it. They never get connected into that realm. And that's what God wants us to do. See, people are only seeking knowledge. Knowledge will puff you up. And there's nothing wrong with knowledge, but there's an area where revelation, two things we want to constantly grab hold of, illumination and revelation. Illumination comes from the Word, where God illuminates. It gives you sight. It illuminates. It gives you sight. What? To see something, to see past, present, or future. Illuminate. It's when the light goes on, it's illuminated, right? It gives you something to see sight. And then there's revelation. Revelation that comes directly from the Father. And in this revelation, what it does is it puts restraints on you. It's like boundaries so that you do not go beyond the boundaries. You don't go back to worldliness. Because the revelation is so powerful, it brings a humbleness and it brings a refreshing connection to the Father. See, what it does is always improving and increasing and proving your identity. Does everybody understand this? Hallelujah. Jesus said, I've come to bring you life and life abundantly, right? By having the advantage to know what is, what was, and what is to come by the regeneration of the Holy Spirit. Everyone say, I'm being regenerated. See, you don't even realize what's going on. We're looking for this, you know, like car wash type of thing. You go in and come out, oh, I smell good, you know. It's a process. It's a regeneration that's going on. In fact, you won't realize it's happening until something occurs or you used to react to it, and now you don't. Man, I used to, man, if that would have happened 2 weeks ago, I would have flipped out. I would have ran. I would have killed somebody. See, that's the regeneration that's going on because you're no longer doing the things because he who's in Christ is a new creation. All things are passing away. All things are becoming new because you're going through the regeneration of the Holy Spirit. But God is trying to bring us in that regeneration in a place, a positional place in the Holy Spirit where we have the advantage of all things. We used to try to take advantage when we were worldly. Hello? But we didn't realize that the enemy was taking advantage of us and we were taking advantage of people because he was using us as puppets. Titus chapter 3. Let me tell you, think about this. Will spiritual advantage give you more victories? Yeah. Titus chapter 3. You know, God is so cool because, you know, people don't even realize, you know, they may be sick, they may be addicted, they may have all kinds of stuff, whatever. But God, you know, the enemy brings this stuff on us, but God will allow, use it to get you into a position, a position of regeneration. How many times do we have to hit the wall of reality to finally say, I'm done with this? Finally surrender. I want to know more. I want to get out of this. And we didn't know how to get out of it. Most of us didn't think God could rescue us. We thought programs could rescue us. Medication could rescue us. Doctors could rescue us. Or money could rescue us. And none of the things ever rescued us. Even relationships could rescue us. But when we were out there doing what we were doing, we ruined everything. Relationships, jobs, no matter what it was. No matter what we touched, turned to poop. It didn't last because we weren't regenerated. And that regeneration of the Holy Spirit, we were still so worldly and carnally. We were the children of darkness, wanting to serve the devil and the lusts and the entanglements and affairs of this world, living for ourselves. Until we finally hit the wall of reality and said, you know what? I got to make a change. The whole thing is When we desire to want to make that change, we cannot make that change. Only the one that created you can change you. So what he's asking us to do is to give him an opportunity to work in our life by cooperating, which is the price, with all of the things of eternity. Because see, the things in the temporary keep you temporary, but the things of eternity begin to change you. What's he trying to do? Restore you to where you were before you came here. See, but most people don't even know that they were already somewhere else before they came here. See, they're so caught up in this world that they lost sight that you were with God before you came here. But as soon as you were born, all memory was removed. That's why we're walking in this world going, who am I? Why am I here? Where am I going? Did you ever realize we're stuck on a planet? Hello? Temporarily? You don't think, look at God's been around for a long time. There's a lot more things that we have no idea. How many other folds he has. What's going on in other parts of the universe or before this universe. This is just a little glimpse. But everything he does is by love. He does it because he loves. He does it because he what? Loves. God is love. Oh, but the enemy loves to contaminate. In Titus chapter 3 and verse 1, let's read it together. It says, remind them to be subject to rulers and authorities, to obey and to be ready for every good work, to speak evil of no one, to be peaceable, gentle, showing all humility to all men. Woo-hoo. For we what? Ourselves were also once what? Foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving various lusts and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful and hating one another. But when the kindness and the love of God our Savior toward man appeared, not by works of righteousness, which we've done, but by according to his mercy he saved us, through the washing of regeneration and the renewing of the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us abundantly through Jesus Christ our Savior, that having been justified by his grace, we should become heirs according to the hope of eternal life. Wow. This is a faithful saying. And these things I want you to affirm when? Constantly. In other words, bringing it to remembrance. That those who have believed in God should be careful to maintain good works. These things are good and profitable to men. But what? Avoid what? Foolish disputes, genealogies, contentions, and strivings about the law. For they are unprofitable and useless. Glory. Regeneration is associated with renewing of the Holy Spirit. We are being refreshed, refilled, so that things can be restored. What do you mean by restored? The kingdom being restored. God is trying to restore his kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. Does everybody got it? He's trying to bring it in here, and it's going to come in through me and you. Another thing he wants us to do is be able to reject the enemy. Why? So the enemy can't take advantage of us. He's going to do everything he can to take advantage of you. He's going to speak to you in multiple ways. He's going to bring trials. He's going to bring discouragement. He's going to bring disappointment. He's going to bring fear. He's going to bring anxiety, stress. All of these, he's going to bring lust. He's going to bring so many things across your path that if you're not taking advantage by the Holy Spirit over the enemy, the enemy's going to take advantage of you. 2 Corinthians chapter 2. Spiritual advantage. 2 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 9. For this end I also what? Wrote that I might put you to the what? Test. Put you to the test. Man, we're tested in everything. Anything and everything we do is tested. That I might put you to the test, whether you are obedient in what? All things. Now whom you forgive anything, I also forgive. For if I indeed I have forgiven anything, I have forgiven that one for your sake in the presence of Christ. Lest Satan should what? Take advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices or his tactics. Let me tell you, the enemy is going to try to take advantage of you. God has sent you here to be trained up, to learn. Has everybody got it? Why? Because if you don't learn, you get burned. Satan tries to take advantage. Many people he takes advantage of because they are ignorant of the things that are going on. They do not have spiritual understanding. Remember, these tactics of Satan bring deception because people are not in position to take advantage. In Revelation chapter 12, it is to your advantage. So would you think that praying in tongues is an advantage? Amen. The gifts of the Spirit are advantages. Revelation chapter 12, I'm sorry. In verse 7, let's read it. And war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought with the dragon, and the dragon and his angels fought. But they did not prevail, nor was a place found for them in heaven any longer. So the great dragon was cast out, the serpent of old, called the devil and Satan, who does what? Deceives the whole world. It's not stopped yet. Who was cast to the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven. Now salvation and strength in the kingdom of our God, and the what? Power of his Christ. And who's the power of his Christ? The Holy Spirit has come, for the accuser of our brethren who accused them before our God day and night has been cast down. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of the testimonies, and they did not love their lives to the death. Therefore rejoice, O heavens, and you who dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down to you having great wrath, because he knows that he has a short time. And I'm telling you, he knows he's got a short time. That's why all hell's breaking out. There's a lot of exposure going on. You ain't seen nothing yet. There are things that you're going to hear that are going to blow you away. I'm talking about multidimensional things that are coming. The people have no idea what's coming. What's going to be revealed. People talking about aliens and all kinds of stuff. There's going to be a lot of things that are getting ready to come. And I can't talk about all those tonight. 1 Peter chapter 5. There are some things that people are not ready to get yet. They just can't get it yet. Why? Because you need the Holy Spirit who interprets. Without the Holy Spirit, you aren't going to interpret. You're not going to understand what's up. You won't digest what's going on. In fact, some of the stuff, it's going to scare the bejeebies out of some people. Whatever a bejeebie is. Sounds like a spirit. I don't know. That's a bejeebie demon. I think it causes people to stutter. I don't know. Bejeebie. Verse 8. Be what? Sober. What's sober mean? Alert. Be alert. Be ready. Beep, 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 beep. You want to be alert. Some people are like, duh, which way did it go? Not alert at all. I'm talking about spiritually alert, although some people aren't even physically alert. Be sober, be alert, and be vigilant, which means consistent. Why? Because your adversary, the devil, is walking about like a roaring lion, seeking who he may what? Devour, deceive. Or trick. It says, resist them steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same sufferings are experienced by your brotherhood in the world. So you ain't the only one going through it when the enemy tells you, you're the only one. I'm the only one. Why me? Oh, poor me. Be sober, be alert, be vigilant, be consistent. Why? Because the enemy's trying to take advantage of you. People don't realize, man, I don't understand why this happens to me. Because you let it. Whining, complaining, blaming everybody else, running, never learning to fight, wanting everybody else to do it for you. Don't work that way. Everyone must work out their salvation. That means you got to turn around and fight the demonic forces and get rid of them, change the atmosphere, and take advantage of the direction and leading and the truth of the Holy Spirit. But you don't understand. No, you don't understand. Everything that happens to you, you allow it. Has everybody got it? That's why God says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Ephesians 1. Ephesians 1, 3. Let's speak it together. Is everybody there? Oh, it's good to hear the pages turning on a Tuesday night. It's like kickstarting a Harley. Verse 3. Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with what? Every spiritual blessing in heavenly places. Hello. Does that give you advantage? Amen. But it says something in Christ. Oh, in Christ. Wait a minute. What's in Christ mean? In the Holy Spirit. See, that's why some people don't know who they are, because they're not staying filled with the Holy Spirit. The enemy comes and drains them. They don't pray in the Spirit enough. They don't decree things. They're waiting for everything else. See, some people don't even fight until they're attacked. And then it's too late. Because it's too hard to fight when you've been wounded. Let me tell you, the devil's like an attorney. He looks for every loophole in your life to access you and destroy you. He tries to get you to sow to the flesh so he can access you. But we are blessed at every spiritual blessing and seated in heavenly places in Christ, just as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world. So he chose you before he created everything. Why? Because you were with him already. He said, I'm going to send you. But let me create this whole universe. Let me get this all set up. And then you can go for me. Like I said before, we probably volunteered. I'll go. I'll go. Who'll go for me? I'll go. I'll go. Really, Lord, I'm going to do it. I'm going to go there and kick butt. I'm going to go there and rescue your people. I'm going to go there and tell the truth. We get born in this place. Where am I? Where am I? How did I get here? What am I doing here? Oh, God. It's amazing how many atheists who say they don't believe in God, but when they get into trouble, the first words out of their mouth is, oh, God! Who am I? Why am I here? Who's my identity? Then the enemy deceives people and tries to bring a false identity to everyone because he'd never want you to know who you are. Because when you do, then he fears you. Hello? Just as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestined us to the adoption as sons and daughters by Jesus Christ into himself, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise and glory of his grace, by which he made us accepted in the beloved. That's powerful. Bless us with spiritual blessings, seated in us in heavenly places. In other words, if you're blessed at every spiritual blessing and seated in heavenly places, you're multidimensional. See, but the enemy wants to keep you in one dimension, caught up here, not realizing that you have access to everything. Everything. Why? Because you're connected to everything by the Spirit of the living God. To take advantage, to have the advantage over the enemy. Does everybody understand? I'm telling you, I can't express this enough. The enemy takes so much advantage over people. It slaps them in the head, trips them up, brings them discouragement, goes into woes as me, makes them wimps, runners and not fighters, never learning, waiting for someone to rescue them, when only Jesus can rescue you. And he does that by changing you. Amen. Glory. In other words, we have access of past, present, and future. The whole thing is learning how to access and being able to hear and being able to see. That's why he says, he who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says. He says to anoint your eyes so that you may see. Matthew 16. Let me tell you, when these demons and fallen angels and non-celestial beings show up, people are going to freak out. They're going to freak out. Because the Lord is going to force them into the physical realm. He's going to drive them into the physical realm. And the word says many people's hearts will boom. It's coming. It's coming. Pretty soon you're going to hear some of the things that the government's going to start to reveal. Matthew 16. In verse 15. And Jesus said to him, but who do you say that I am? And Simon Peter answered, Lord, you are the what? The Christ. The Son of the living God. Jesus answered and said, blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood did not reveal this to you. In other words, that was revelation. Why? Because it came by my Father who is in heaven. The Father is the one who brings revelation. And I also say to you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. On what rock? Christ. The what? The anointing. The eternal presence, power, and truth of God Almighty. What? Carried by the Holy Spirit. And I will give you the what? Keys. Everyone say keys. Of the what? Kingdom of heaven. Now what an honor that is. Talk about advantage, getting the keys of heaven. Many people's keys are getting rusty. They're just hanging off the side, don't even know they're there. Never even using them. And I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loose in heaven. That's why we put it in the penetrating prayer booklets. You got to speak it. So that it becomes a practice to you. Why? You bind every spirit. And whatever you speak in this realm is going right through into the unseen realm. Whatever you loose in this realm is loosening in that realm. In other words, whatever you're speaking in this realm here, because his breath is penetrating every area. That's why it's called a penetrating prayer booklet. Because you are penetrating the powers of darkness. You are penetrating into the unseen realm. Remember, we're not fighting one another. We are changing atmospheres. That's why when we praise and worship, we change the atmosphere. What are we doing? Driving out powers of darkness. So when you're clapping, you're going, shoo, shoo, shoo. You're shooing those demons out of here. And if you're not one worshiping, those demons got to go somewhere when they leave. You mean that's why I'm struggling so much? Yeah, because you won't lift your hands to heaven and you won't open your stinking mouth. Too busy looking at everybody else. Look at. When the presence of God comes, demons run. They leave people. And they got to go somewhere. And they're looking for anyone. They're not a respecter of person. Hello? Keys of the kingdom of heaven in Christ. What an advantage. Why? By maintaining the connection to the realm. Two realms. I want to talk about the two realms. The realm of illumination and a realm of revelation. What is it? It's resulting in the manifestation and the victory of battle, giving you advantage every time. Every time. Remember, well, this is a ministry of life, isn't it? What life he's given us, we're to be able to give life. But you got to be careful of false illuminations. Because the enemy loves to come and bring a false illumination. And he brings an emotion behind it. Oh! See, if you don't get revelation about it or confirmation from it, don't move on it. Always get two things, at least two things to confirm it. Acts chapter 1. Never go by how you feel. 1:8. Spiritual advantage. And Jesus said, you shall receive what? Power. Everyone say power.
Power.
Power. Not to run a car. Power for what? Over the enemy. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall take advantage of the enemy. And you shall be what? Witnesses to me in Jerusalem and Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. Power in Christ. Ephesians 3. Hallelujah. Come on, we're multidimensional. Let's go. We should know what pages are coming up next. And I used to try to do that all the time. I'd be sitting in church and I go, Holy Spirit, what's next? Where does he go next? Why? Because it was helping me learn his voice. Learn his unction. And most of the time it's unction, not even voice. What's he doing next, Holy Spirit? What's the next one? Ooh. See, we got to learn his unction. And you must do it by practice, or you'll never get it. Ephesians 3, verse 14. Can we speak this, please? For this reason, I bow my knees to the what? Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, from whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might through his Spirit in the inner man, that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the width and length and depth and height, to know the love of Christ which passes knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Isn't that God's desire? Now to him who's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think. Come on, read it with me. According to the power that works where? In us, what gives us advantage. To him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. The power that works in us. The power that works in us. Everyone say, the power that works in me. The regeneration of the Holy Spirit. Which makes me multidimensional. Ooh. See, people are just caught up in what? Feelings. Those things keep you in one realm. Making emotional decisions, fears, all of these things. What about me? You know what we need to do? Disappear. Hello. We need to be transparent. The government's been trying to do that for centuries. They still can't. We need to be transparent. In fact, the word talks about gold. When you heat gold, you know what happens? It becomes invisible. It's transparent. We need to be, in other words, Christ, the illumination of Christ in me and you makes me and you transparent. Well, we're not looking at us anymore. Amen? The only thing we're looking at is Christ. Looking at doing his will, not our own. Glory. 2 Peter 1. Let's speak it. Grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of our Lord Jesus. Or Jesus our Lord. As his what? Divine power has given to us what? All things. Divine power is given to us all things that pertain to life or existence and godliness through the knowledge of him who called us by glory and virtue, by which have been given to us exceedingly great and precious promises, that through these you may be what? Partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. In other words, he's giving us all of these promises that allow you to be seated in heavenly places and live from the future to the present. So that you know everything that you're doing here, even though you're doing things to maintain in this realm by working or whatever, but your focus is on laboring unto the Lord. No matter what you do, it's always unto him, always unto him, always unto him. Why? Because you're looking beyond the temporary. You're looking into the eternal. And you're looking to see what you can bring from the eternal realm into a temporary realm to expand the kingdom of God. That's what you and I are called for. We didn't just get rescued, hello, to build our own empire. We got rescued to build his kingdom. That's what you volunteered to come into this realm for. Has everybody got it? Oh, glory. Divine power, divine nature. In other words, that's your identity. Who you are. We are no longer the bloodline of the world. We are the bloodline of the kingdom of Christ. That's your blood. You have new blood. Does everybody get this? This is spiritual blood. You have a new DNA. You are eternal, already eternal. You don't have to wait to get into eternity. You've already in eternity. And you only got one breath away from home. So we should be acting like kingdom kids, soldiers, warriors, expressing the character of Christ Jesus. Wherever you are, whatever you do, being ready in season and out of season to lay hands on, to cast out devils, to do whatever, express the kingdom, to love someone in Christ. Matthew 10. We are the children of the Most High, soldiers of the Most High, ambassadors. Matthew 10, verse 32. Jesus said something powerful here. Therefore, whoever what? Confesses me before men, him I will also confess before my Father who is in heaven. Ooh. Whoever denies me before men, him I will also deny before my Father who is in heaven. Bummer. It's a bummer to know the truth and not practice it. Do not think that I have come to bring peace on earth. There will never be peace on earth. Only till the Prince of Peace comes. I did not come to bring peace, but what? But what? A sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And a man's enemies will be those of his own household. Boy, is he right. He who loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. Whoa-hoo! Come on, speak that with me. Verse 37. Everybody. He who loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he who loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he who does not take his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. He who finds his life will lose it. And he who loves his life for my sake will find it. That is powerful. This is reality. Mark 16. I see you slacking, I'm going to call you out. No more playing. I don't play, either should you. You're not willing to fight, you're in the wrong place. You want wimp? Go to wimpy place. This is soldiers, warriors. Amen?
Amen.
Glory. Mark 16, 16. He who believes, is everybody there? And is baptized will be saved, but he who does not believe will be what?
Amen.
Condemned. And what's the word believe mean?
Follow.
And these signs will follow those who what? Believe in my name, they will what? Cast out demons. I love it. Isn't that amazing that that's the first thing he says? You're going to cast out demons because that's the problem. It isn't your job. And quit listening to these stupid spirits that tell you to drift. Slack. Do things you shouldn't do things. Quit listening to them. Doubt and fear. Oh, those are my thoughts. No, they're not, bonehead. They're not your thoughts. Those are voices and influence of the unseen realm. And until you get that, you're going to constantly stay in the cycle of deception. That must be an understanding. That's why Jesus came, to expose the unseen. That's why you've been called, to expose the unseen. In my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents. And if they drink anything deadly, it by no means hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick and they will what? Recover. Sometimes you just need to lay hands on yourself. I can't tell you how many times I baptized myself in my own tub. And I don't care. Praise God. Colossians 2. You got to become serious. Colossians chapter 2. Is everybody there? Verse 11. Let's speak it. In him you were also circumcised with the circumcision made without hands by putting off the body of the sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ. In other words, Christ was crucified for me and you. Buried with him in baptism, in which you also were raised with him through faith in the working of God who raised him from the dead. And you being dead to your trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, he made alive together with him, having forgiven you all trespasses, having wiped out the handwriting of the requirements that was against us, which was contrary to us. And he has taken it out of the way, having nailed it to the cross. Look at verse 15. Having disarmed the principalities and the powers, he made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them in it. Now, in other words, he disarmed the powers of darkness against me and you. We have the advantage over the powers of darkness. The only reason why people are not taking the advantage of it is because they keep agreeing with the voice of the stranger. They keep opening their mouths. They keep touching things. They're giving the enemy a place. That's why the Bible says, make no place for the devil. Stop it. Or you get buried alive. The enemy wants to kill you. This is reality. You give a loop, a little place for him. It's like a rowboat that has a pinhole in it. You think everything's fine. You're out there swimming until you're halfway in the middle of the lake. And it starts coming in. And you can't plug it. You're trying to get to the shore and you're going to drown by the time you get there. Make no place for the devil. Take advantage. You have the advantage over the enemy. Use the tools. Use the weapons. Use the keys. You're placing spiritual blessings and seated in heavenly places. God has already given me and you the victory. Do you understand that? We have to walk it out. We have to continue to battle for that. Moving out the powers of darkness. Does everybody understand?
Amen.
Go to 1 John chapter 2. spiritual advantage. Again, most people don't even know they got the spiritual advantage. Oh, hallelujah. Spiritual advantage. 1 John chapter 2 and verse 12. I write to you, little children, because your sins are forgiven you for his name's sake. I write to you, fathers, because you have known him who is from the beginning. I write to you, young men, because you have overcome the wicked one. I write to you, little children, because you have known the Father. I've written to you, fathers, because you have known him who is from the beginning. I have written to you, young men, because you are strong, and the word of God abides in you, and you have overcome the wicked one. Do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world is passing away in the lust of it. But he who does the will of God abides forever. But he who does the will of God abides forever. But he who does the will of God abides forever. And the word of God that abides in you allows you to overcome the wicked one. Why? Because the word of God is truth. Again, it goes back to the truth. Do you know the truth? Do you practice the truth? Do you love the truth? Do you express the truth? Do you decree the truth? The truth is light, it's life, and it's freedom. 1 John chapter 5. Is everybody there? We know that whoever is born of God does not sin, but he who has been born of God keeps himself, and the wicked one does not touch him. Hello? You've been born of the Spirit? Then the wicked one should not touch you. Amen? You know, he keeps making these little airplanes and throwing them on, and then people open them up, and there's a message. Uh-huh. It's amazing how many people still read their fortune cookies. They go to these Chinese places, open up, and read a fortune cookie. What an idiot. It's because they don't know who they are. Well, maybe God's got a message. Yeah, he's got a message. Repent and try again. Verse 19. We know that we are of God, and the whole world lies under the sway of the wicked one. And we know that the Son of God has come and given us an understanding that we may know him who is true, and we are in him who is true, in his Son Jesus Christ. This is the true God and eternal life. Little children, keep yourself from what? Idols, anything that will get between you and God. Philippians. Philippians 2. Spiritual advantage. You know, God has given us wisdom. He's given us understanding. He's given us everything. People don't use it. They're waiting. You know, there's a time to wait on God, and there's a time when God is waiting on me and you. Hallelujah. To do what? Repent. Turn away from wickedness. Get in position. You know, the word says something powerful. It says when you do the will of God, when God asks you to do something, after you've completed, he releases a promise. So many times people don't complete what God's asking them to do, and they never get the promise. And they run around. Oh, man. And they go from one place to another trying to find the blessing or the promise of God, and it ain't coming. And, you know, how many of y'all know the devil can bless you? Yeah, he can bless you. And you'd be misled. Philippians chapter 2 and verse 1. Would you read it with me, please? Therefore, if there is any consolation in Christ, if any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any affection and mercy, fulfill my joy by being what? Like-minded. Having the same love. being of one accord and of what? One mind. Let nothing be done through selfish ambition or conceit, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem others better than himself. Let each of you look out not only for his own interests, but also interests of others. Now listen, this is important. Why? Listen, you don't want to associate with anyone that's not willing to protect you from the world. Does everybody get this? You want to be protected from the world lust. I don't want my daughter to go out with men that ain't willing to protect her from the world. Does everybody get this? You should not approve of those things. We don't want to be associated with people that will not protect us, agree with us on the arena of protecting us from the world. Does everybody get that? Like-minded, look out for interests of others. Hang with those that will protect you from worldliness, Satan's deceptions and tactics, and not encourage worldliness. Hello? Let each of you look out not only for his own interests, but also the interests of others. Verse 5. Let this what? Mind be in you, which also is in Christ Jesus, who being in a form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking a form of a bondservant, and coming in the likeness of men. And being found in the appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even to the death of the cross. Therefore, God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of those in heaven and those on earth and those under earth, that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord, to the glory of God the Father. 2 Timothy chapter 2, and we'll close here. That's why the word says, do not be unevenly yoked with unbelievers. Why? Because they're not going to protect you from worldliness. They're not going to tell you, oh man, you know, you shouldn't do that. No, you shouldn't drink that. No, you shouldn't do that. Does everybody get it? No, man, you shouldn't go to that place. But those of the world will promote worldliness, and it will cause you to open doors to demonic activity in your life. Boy, I got quiet in here. Is everybody cool? Second Timothy chapter 2 and verse 1. You therefore, my son and daughter, be what? Strong in the grace, the plan of God that is in Christ Jesus. And the things that you have heard from me among many witnesses, commit these to faithful men who will be able to teach others also. You therefore must what? Endure hardship as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. No one engaged in warfare entangles himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who enlisted him as a soldier. Why? Because you're going to get your butt kicked if you do. The entanglements and affairs of this life is the approval of worldliness. Verse 5. And also, if anyone competes in athletics, he is not crowned unless he competes according to the rules. The hardworking farmer must be first to partake of the crops. Consider what I say, and may the Lord give you understanding in these things. Remember that Jesus Christ, the seed of David, was raised from the dead according to my gospel, for which I suffer trouble as an evildoer, even to the point of chains. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I endure all things for the sake of the elect, that they may also obtain the salvation which is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. This is a faithful saying. If we died with him, we shall also live with him. If we endure, we shall also reign with him. If we deny him, he will also deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful. He cannot deny himself. Remind them of these things, charging them before the Lord, not to strive about words to no profit, to the ruin of the hearers. Be diligent to present yourself approved to God, a worker who does not need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. But what? Shun what? Profane and idle babblings, which they will increase to more ungodliness. And this message will spread like what? Cancer. Hello. Shut it down. When you see things beginning to happen, shut it down. Don't approve of it. What are you doing then? You're opening the door. Take advantage of what you have learned. Take advantage over the enemy. Don't let them take advantage over you. Too many people are going astray. And they're missing what God's trying to do. Look at you and I are alive in this realm to do His will, not our own. And we've got to come to that understanding and the conclusion that we got to come to a place where it's no longer we that live, but Him that lives. You have spiritual advantage in the spirit realm. Take advantage. Use it so the enemy doesn't kick you around. Amen? You're to be kicking him around. Why? So we can bring the kingdom of God, the eternal place, into a temporary place. Amen? Praise God. Father, we thank you for your word. We are honored and blessed. Allow the seed that's been implanted in us tonight spread to every part of our being with illumination, with revelation, and with confirmation, so that you may be manifested in us and through us to fulfill your will on earth in a temporary place. It is in heaven, in the eternal place, in Jesus' name. And everybody said amen.
Amen.
Amen. Be filled, dressed, and possessed by the Spirit of the living God.